It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangylawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.
I'm going to call to order the meeting of the Livingston Parish, regular meeting of Livingston Parish Council for February 25th, 2021. Tonight's invocation will be delivered by Councilman John Wasco.
Lord, we take just a moment to come before you as council members and servants for this parish. I pray that you help us make decisions that are based off of godly principles. And Lord, your same spirit that directed our forefathers who built this country when they established laws, that you allow us to be sensitive to that same spirit. So when we pass legislation, it reflects the same legislation that you have for us. And that legislation that you have for us is not necessarily the Ten Commandments, but it's that one commandment that supersedes all, and that is the commandment of love. Help us to do everything we do out of love, one for another, so your name can be seen and your presence can be felt through us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Mr. DeLatte, could you lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance, please?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Ms. Sandy, would you please call the roll?
Mr. Wasson.
Here.
Mr. R.
Here.
Mr. Calvert.
Here.
Mr. Harris.
Here.
Mr. McMorris.
Here.
Mr. DeLatte.
Here.
Here. Mr.
Mack. Mr. Mack is not with us tonight. He is at Albany watching a
basketball game. I'm here.
I'd like to ask everybody at this time to take time to look at your cell phone. Be sure it's muted or the volume's turned down. And I want to talk about item six, public input. There'll be items tonight that the public gets to address. We'll identify those and open public input and give you an opportunity to speak. We have no presentations tonight, so we'd like to start off with item 8, public hearing and adoption of LP 21-03. Ms. Sandy, would you read by title?
This is proposed ordinance 21-03. This is an ordinance to amend Chapter 125 of Code of Ordinances of Livingston Parish Subdivision Regulations, Article 1 in general, Sections 125-24, Drainage Impact Study, 125-25, Drainage Impact Study, Drainage Design Requirement, 125-27, Driveway Culverts and or Subsurface Drainage, as follows.
At this point in time, we'd like to open the public hearing. If there's anyone like to speak on this ordinance, please come with the microphones, the podium, state your name and address. No takers on the public hearing. We'd like to close the public hearing. We can take a motion now. You got a motion by Mr. DeLatte in support. Second by Mr. Gerlinghaus. Does the council want to discuss this at all? This is something that we've buried ourselves in for quite a while in giving waivers, and I think we're done if we pass this. So is there any discussion from the council?
Mr. Chairman, I didn't see anywhere where it said free culverts to the general public.
No, it doesn't say free public. It doesn't say nothing about free culverts. It just says it. So at this point in time, if there being no initial discussion, I'd like to call for the vote. Is there any objection? No objection. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
The ayes have it. Item 9, public hearing and adoption of LP 21-04. Ms. Sandy, would you read by title, please?
This is an ordinance to amend Chapter 58, Roads and Drainage, Article 4, Utilities, Installation, and Rights of Ways. Section 58-419, notification as follows.
Before opening the public hearing, I'll make a statement. We had some response from some utility companies. There's one in particular that does a lot of work in the parish that has requested that we defer this 2 weeks. We're going to grant that request to them, but by law, we have to open a public hearing because we advertise it, so we're going to open a public hearing now, and if anybody would like to speak, they're more welcome to step up to the podium and state your name and address and speak on this item. Nobody wants to speak. We're going to close the public hearing. Can we get a motion to defer this 2 weeks? Motion by Mr. R.
Second.
Second by Mr. King. And there being no objection, everybody's agreement, aye?
Aye.
Ayes have it. We're going to move on to item 10, which is the adoption of the minutes from the February 11th, 2021 regular meeting of council. Do I have a motion? Motion by Mr. Gerlinghouse. Second by Mr. R. Any objection? There being none, we're going to, that item carries. Item 11, Parish President's Report. The Parish President sent in his designee, Ms. Jennifer Myers, the Budget Director. Ms. Jennifer, you want to talk about item A?
Yes, sir. So item A, we're asking to introduce an ordinance declaring some immovable property as surplus. I'm sure as you're aware, the parish owns multiple buildings that are now vacant due to some moving or not use anymore. The assessor's office is one. The registrar of voters will be moving to the new assessor building, so the registrar of voters office will be open and empty. We have the mosquito abatement building. There's some various lots that we've acquired over the years. This all sort of started because we had some people reach out to us wanting these buildings, and we got notification from our insurance agent. I believe I told you previously that property insurance is projected to increase. He has been seeing 70% increases on some municipalities that he writes for, and it's the average is about 40%. So we're trying to dump everything that we're not using or we will not use as soon as possible.
Mr. Chairman, I make that motion.
Okay. Ms. Sandy, you want to read by title, please?
This will be proposed ordinance 21-05. This is an ordinance authorizing the Livingston Parish Council to declare a certain immovable property surplus. The public hearing will be at 6 p.m. on March the 11th.
Okay. Let's move on to the addendum at this point in time. Since Ms. Jennifer's here, Ms. Sandy. Well, wait, it's the introduction, so it's just to just read it and move on now. Okay. I know. I understand. Let's move to the addendum since Ms. Jennifer's here. You want to talk?
We're asking for a resolution to support restoration of the New Orleans East Land Bridge. There is a letter that's proposed that's attached to your information that will come on from administration, signed by Mr. Ricks. I believe the council just has to do a resolution in support of this letter.
Ms. Sand, you want to read the resolution for the council?
This is a resolution to add Livingston Parish to the letter of support for the New Orleans East Land Bridge project to be considered for funding by the Museum Trustee Implementation Group. Whereas the deep water horizon oil spill impacted near shore coastal marsh habitat throughout Louisiana, including the New Orleans East Land Bridge. And whereas in addition to impacts from the oil spill, canal dredging, levees, wave exposure, subsidence, and sea level rise have caused erosion and recession of the shoreline, leading to significant deep degradation of vital marsh habitat. Whereas the land bridge separates the Gulf of Mexico and Lake Warren from Lake Pontchartrain, and without action, is on track to largely disappear in the next 50 years. And whereas the land bridge provides vital wetland and estuarine functions, including control of tidal flow between the Gulf of Mexico and Lake Pontchartrain, benefiting the ecosystem and the people who rely on a healthy estuary for their livelihoods. And whereas the land bridge also serves as an important habitat for hundreds of species of fish and wildlife, including sturgeon and migratory birds. And whereas the land bridge reduces storm surge and provides storm protection for over 1 million people who live around Lake Pontchartrain and Lake Maurepas, including communities in Livingston Parish. And whereas the City of New Orleans and the Louisiana Coastal Protection and Restoration Authority have a large-scale restoration project on the land bridge in early planning stages, but major funding is needed to implement the project. And whereas the project would create 1,500 acres of brackish marsh habitat and over 4 miles of living shoreline protection in Lake Warren along the eastern perimeter of the marsh creation area. And whereas project proposals are currently being accepted through the Deepwater Horizon Natural Resource Damage Assessment Process. And whereas This is a potential opportunity to fund a large-scale project on the Land Bridge. Therefore, be resolved that the Livingston Parish Council add Livingston Parish to a letter of support that will be submitted for consideration with the City of New Orleans East Land Bridge Project Proposal to the Louisiana Trustee Implementation Group before the March 2nd, 2021 deadline.
Chairman, a question. That is coming out of which fund, Jennifer?
No, sir, there's no cost to us.
No.
We're just supporting their application to the state fund for that purpose.
I just want to make sure it's not come out of a fund that we participate in and it pushes us further down the list.
No, sir.
I'll make a motion.
Got a motion by Mr. Gerlinghouse, second by Mr. Arb. Any objection from the members of the council? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
The ayes have it. Thank you, Ms. Myers. We're going to return back to the regular agenda. Item 12 would be a presentation of a repaving petition from Westminster Subdivision Homeowners Association. Signed petition is from all homeowners and residents of Westminster Subdivision to have their subdivision roads overlaid. This is requested by Ms. Ruth Metz and Ms. Catherine Roussel and supported by Mr. Gerald McMorris. Ms. Ruth and Ms. Catherine, would y'all like to come up to the podium, state your name and address, and talk to us about your concerns?
Catherine Roussel, 26029 Big Bend. And our concern is our road has too many potholes. It was laid in before Katrina. And it has been patched but never done correctly.
Okay, my name is Geraldine Metz here, and I'm a
substitute
for Mrs. Metz. I live at 26048 Big Bend Drive in Denham Springs. And the reason we came, we love our neighborhood, but the potholes, we call and they come out and they fill the potholes, it rains, the potholes are back. We do the same thing over and over and over again. And when we originally moved into our subdivision, the roads were really good. And then what happened was Chinese drywall. And then the big trucks came back hauling out the sheetrock and whatever goes into building a house. So the roads were kind of like, took a big beating from the big trucks coming in and moving things out. But what we're asking is that if you could consider repaving it. I brought some petitions from our neighbors, we would like you guys to really consider it, please, because we keep calling about potholes. If you look on the list, you'll see Big Bend Drive, Westminster. I call all the time. I'm the caller mainly, I guess.
And we have pictures of the roads.
And I have pictures of the roads, and I have some petitions. I'm in there, yes. Yes, please.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to address Mr. Gerald has a speaking problem tonight with his voice, and I'm going to cover some of the things he asked me to cover. Your petition is duly noted and takes in, but you're probably competing against another 400 miles of road, and we're doing like 12 miles a year. I don't want to give you false hope, but I also want to give you something that you may can hang your hat on. If active citizens group works, and that's what you're doing now, I'm a firm believer that we can blacktop every road and that needs blacktopping in Livingston Parish in the next 2 to 3 years. But for that to happen, we have to have 5 votes on this council. So far, we haven't had 5 votes. And everybody has a different opinion. I'm not saying mine's the right opinion, but I know I sat on this council in 92 and 96 and now. And every time we ever overlaid the roads in the parish, we did it on what's called a grant. We took the money on the sales tax. The road that I live on myself was built in 1960 and it got overlaid in 2008.
Mm-hmm.
So that's one time. I have probably 250 miles of road myself in the district that I have. I got 2 miles of road today, this year. Gerald is in the same petition, the same spot. And we as a council, we don't get to pick what roads get done. That's done by engineering group that scores the road. And based on the priority of the road and severity of it and the traffic. I do think that a citizen group works everywhere that I've seen, and you're going to be paying 15 years on 1 cent sales tax. And if you happen to fall and not get your road blacktop in 15 years,
I don't know if I have 15 years.
You probably paid $50,000-$60,000 and still didn't get your road blacktop. Okay. So that might be something you may want to do, is start a citizen group, because it's got to be us that says, okay, we want to bond the money. And if that's something we do and make a budget to do that, then it's going to be like all the other years that we had. We was able to overlay the roads in those, and those are years. This 15-year petition, I mean a bond that we have out now, I don't think you have to bond for 15. I think you can do for 8 years. And I think you can overlay every road on that 8 year and still collect money for the public works. Public works could also help, because these roads are now fixed, and they can also help by any kind of construction, by doing drainage or sign or anything like that. We have a guy that we rely on, Jim Ryan, based on what Mr. McMorris was telling me today about the concern of wanting to help y'all. At the next agenda meeting, I'm going to put that on there, that he comes and talk to us and ask us, what can we do, tell us, inform us, what can we do to get the people on the roads, good roads fixed.
Well, I just want to tell you this as well. My granddaughter had me wear this grandma rock button. And, you know, you guys see this? So yeah. I thought maybe they might kind of nudge you a little bit.
They do. Grandma's rock.
Mr. McMorris, it's my understanding that all the roads that are on this list are already on the
yes.
priority road list. Does anybody have a recognition or a remembrance of how those roads scored in the last, any idea, high, low?
I don't.
Okay. I just was curious.
The problem is they rescore them every year. So even if they, you know, up here.
Mr. Chairman,
yes,
I've had some subdivisions that have had some base failures in them in the same type of vein. I go through there occasionally through those subdivisions up there, too, in Woodland Cross and Westminster. DPW has come through where we could not fix the whole road, cut the sections out, and put new blacktop in. It doesn't look as pretty as a whole new road, but they fixed all the base failures in Pecan Creek. No more potholes. It's been 2 years now, and it did not sink again. They packed it with limestone and got the paving, the actual road overlay company to do it with the rollers and not just coal mix. You know, because we put coal mix in it, it, like you said, it rains.
It rains,
it water gets under it, you hit it one time, and out it comes again. But that may be something we can address soon, with if we have some excess dollars coming through, like in April when Jennifer's going to let us know about, maybe we'll take your portion and do that. Because if not, unless we bond out part of our road fund like Randy's talking about, it may be 10 years.
Look, at this point, it'd be time to entertain a motion to accept these resolutions and pass them on to the administration.
Right.
Yeah. Got a motion by Mr. McMorris, second by Mr. DeLatte. Is there any objection from the council?
No.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Ladies, thank y'all very much.
Yes.
Thank y'all.
Item 13, discussion of closing Sand Hill Road located in Council District 1, Mr. Jeff Averett. Jeff Hard. I still have Jeff Averett on my mind from reading the item last year. We put these on the list in 18.
Well, I've had many calls from Mr. Bankston on this. And I know he's been communicating with St. Helena as well. I will attest that this is a very bad area for dumping. I know there's an issue. I think we're just going to have some stuff that we got to figure out as far as our legal, what we can legally allow to happen. I was hoping Mr. Moody would be here tonight to kind of advise us on that. But Mr. Bankston is here to state his case and name and address, and the floor is yours.
Thank you, sir. Mike Bankston's my name. Address is 39870 Sand Hill Road. I've got some literature. Can I pass that out, please?
Sure.
This will help get us all on the same page. Yes. This will help us all be on the same page of what we're looking at and what we're asking for.
Do
Has this road been closed before?
It is currently closed now.
It's actually been washed out for a while. Probably about 3 years, Mike, it's been washed out?
Yes, sir, that's correct.
So it ain't, you ain't in a big four-wheel drive truck, you're not going through it?
Not even that. First of all, on our pamphlets here, you'll see a letter from St. Helena. This is from the president, Frankie Johnson, and it's got his signature on the closing of the, on the Livingston Parish St. Helena line, which is on the east side of my property. And I own property on both sides of the road, St. Helena as well as Livingston. And so I've been working in conjunction with St. Helena to get that done, and they were very happy to do so. If you'll look at some of the first pictures, let's see, we'll go, this is a map of where it is, if anyone's questioning where Sandhill Road is. And then there's a second map that shows where the gates are. You got the Sandhill side, or I'm sorry, the St. Helena side, which would be on the east. And then what we're asking for is the gate to the west side, which is the west side of my property. I'm not asking for parish property, road, nothing. I want to be able to gate my own property that I'm paying taxes on that right there as of now. If you'll pass that map page and you go to the first several pictures, this is all on the St. Helena side. This is what Livingston Parish is doing to St. Helena. We're not being a very good neighbor to St. Helena. Yeah. It's kind of sad. I do have a picture of my dog in there. He's a good dog, if you want good, something good about it. But as you go through the pictures and come towards the back, you'll see some wildlife. And the wildlife is poaching problems on my property. And they'll shoot and clean the deer right there in 30 seconds and be gone. And here's another picture towards the back. These are stolen vehicles that come from I don't know where. And they have been burnt, and I think they were reported to Livingston Parish. And they did their reports on the stolen vehicles. Sandhill Road is used for a lot of mischief, you know, and that's something that we're trying to cut down on. Here's another deer that was poached on my property. I heard that deer when it was shot. I fed both of her yearlings all last summer, and then I walked out there to the end of my property, and they had cut the back straps out of her and was gone. Here's a freezer that went out from somebody from the freeze. Had all their stuff in it, and my house is right back in behind it, and there's all their stuff right there in the middle of the road. Let's see. And they have some people that's actually not capable of taking their name and address off of their garbage. You'll look and see in there, they have the names and addresses on some of the photos there. Here's a young lady that dumped all of her stuff out and had pictures of herself and where she worked and check stubs and everything. Here's her load of garbage right here on my property. So yeah, as you can go through the pictures, you can kind of see what we're dealing with. I'm not making this stuff up. And what I'm asking for, fellas, is if you'll look at the map, you have a Leggett Road and Sandhill Road. My property's on both roads. I own both of them. I pay taxes on all of that square footage. And what I'm asking for is a gate that will help St. Helena, which has already went out of their way to shut their end down, and to make it more successful, to have a successful campaign here, we need Livingston to participate and help cut out the dumping altogether. So this is my property right here as well. I'm not asking for anything from Livingston or nobody. I just want permission to put a gate there. And right here at the Leggett Sand Hill Crossing. This is an excellent spot for a turnaround for people that is coming through there and realizes that there's a gate there now and needs to turn around. This is big enough for 18-wheelers, for any size vehicle to turn around. So, like I said, I'm not asking for anything. I just want permission to protect my property. Here's another thing while you're looking at your pictures. I've got some audio for you. These are gunshots. The first night I wasn't able to record them. The second night, about 12 o'clock during the night, I said, well, I'm going to record this and send it to my rep, just so he'll know what's going on back there. But that's just a few shots there. First night was probably 200-300 rounds. Second night was another 300-400 rounds. I said, that's enough. It's a very unsafe place to live. You guys can make it better for us all. You can help us make a better neighbor to St. Helena by shutting this thing off and helping control the dumping, help control the shooting, help control. I got bullet holes in my house. And I don't know when it was done, but they're there. I can show them to you.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to ask a question.
Yes, sir, Mr. Blatt.
How far is the distance between those two gates?
Approximately, it's going to be around 1,200, 1,500 feet.
And you own property on both sides of the gates?
I own all of it. The road does not go anywhere. It goes on my property and stops on my property. It does not serve any purpose for Livingston Parish. It does not have any function whatsoever. You can't go through there to go nowhere. On the St. Helena side, which is the east side, is it's not blocked off now, but it will be after this meeting because I already have permission from St. Helena to do so. So it will be blocked off, so the road is closed. It's not open any longer. But we're asking for participation from Livingston to get it done properly.
I got a question. So that the St. Helena side is all, well, not gravel, it's all just holes.
Yeah.
So how far past the proposed gate is blacktopped?
I'm sorry?
How far past the proposed gate you want to put is the actual blacktop? Does it go all the way to the other gate?
Well, the blacktop will go from the Livingston Parish St. Helena line. It'll come up about 1,000 feet to the other side of my property, and that's where we want the other gate.
That's the only question I have, is if it's legal to block a blacktop part. That's the only question I would have. So otherwise, it needs to be done. We get that.
From my understanding on the ordinances of that, if the road serves no purposes, that it can
be
turned over.
Yeah, that's what we need to ask. That's all I
guess my question is, though, in the future, if they decide to open, if St. Helena decides to put their side, they can just lift their gate, then we'll lose the access through.
I can answer that. That gate is not our, that road is not a public road. There's not four landowners in there, myself and three others, all the way to St. Helena. And, or not St. Helena, but all the way for 2 miles past that. So there's no reason for that road to be open for nobody. Nobody has no business back there because they don't own anything.
You're talking about under normal conditions, if the road was fixed and good? I'm just saying nobody's back there now because you can't make the trip through.
Correct.
But if you can make the trip through, then people would use that road to cut through.
Well, it's a privilege, not a right, because it's not a public road.
Who owns the road?
The timber companies.
I mean, we paved it, right?
Only a portion of it.
He's talking about the St. Helena side.
Oh.
Yeah.
On the St. Helena side of my property, that's all private property. That's not public. So anyone that has been using it or going to use it is a privilege. It's not a right.
Which one did you have?
Mike, I'm a little confused because I talked to Mr. Frank Johnson yesterday.
Okay.
And he was telling me the gate was going to go at Neesum Lane, right there where the gravel starts off the blacktop.
Well, that was their option. They want to gate it off there to keep anyone from coming down. The problem is crime. St. Helena's biggest qualm is crime, and they get so many calls coming down there, and they want to reduce their calls, and it reduces their cost, and it reduces their time and energy. So if they can block it off down at the Neesum Road, from Neesum Road to my place, I don't know, it's probably 1.5 to 2 miles or so, that's private property. So if you travel that, it's a privilege. It's not a right. And so Neesum Road, I don't know if it's private or public. I can't answer that. I only know that our road on our property with only 3 landowners is private property.
Did they re-blacktop Neesum?
No, sir. I know that was on the agenda, but I don't know how much.
I think it's public.
I drove by there the other day and I saw the blacktop from 16 and I was surprised to see it. I said, wow,
I think they just redone it. So that might
it's
be
possible.
Public roads.
But from Neesum Road forward is all private property.
Right.
Because there's hunting clubs in there and there's been threats from the owners a few times that if the hunting clubs didn't clean up the garbage and the trash and the things that were going on back there, they were just going to pull the leases from them. And so they had a cleanup day, went through there, picked up all the garbage and tried to make their landlord happy, and they did.
Yeah.
And but like I said, from Neesum to Leggett is actually private property.
So the road that we're already intending on putting a gate at the parish line.
Correct.
That's where you're putting the other gate.
Yes, sir. So it's the road is closed now. There's no going through there, not because of the hole and the physical problems, but you won't be able to go through there because I'm gating it.
Okay, so you're going to gate it at the parish line because the same lady gave you permission.
Correct.
What you're asking us to do is to allow you to gate it all the way up at Lake.
Correct,
okay,
yes.
So we're going to need an opinion from Chris Moody on this, and he's not here, so probably now would be an appropriate time to just defer this item until Chris can evaluate and give us an opinion.
That's the only answer I need is if we can. If we can, I would be okay with just blocking it off. You know?
Your ordinances allow you to do that. If the road serves no purpose, it can be turned over to the landowner.
But we can't determine
but
that.
We need our lawyer to tell us.
Yeah.
So who wants anybody want to make a motion to defer?
Yeah.
I got Michael, so I'm not trying to be condescending here. I'm just saying, we own the road, right?
Yeah.
No, sir.
Oh, it's asphalt and it's our road.
Well, my property taxes says it's mine.
Well, if we paved it, by default, it became parish property. Did we pave this road?
Yes. And if it's maintained for 3 years, it becomes parish property.
No, if it's maintained for 3 years,
road.
It becomes public.
Yeah, public road.
Yeah.
So the difference between public and parish property. So
clear that up because we've said.
But anyway, I mean,
I understand why you.
Well, let's get that determination from Chris too.
So how much of it would actually be blacktop? How long would that section be?
Approximately 1,000 feet.
1,000 feet.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we have a motion to defer.
I'd make a motion to defer. I mean, I've
got a motion from Jeff to defer. Second, until we get an opinion from Chris Moody.
I think that's right.
Any other discussion?
I commend a motion that would put it back on next meeting's agenda so the gentleman can get an answer.
Yes.
We're going to
just motion to defer 2 weeks and have Chris come here and give us a
report. Then we'll have a definitive answer that night.
I don't really have a problem. I know everything he's talking about. I'm good with it.
Look,
I just want the lawyer
to tell me. I used to ride up and down that road in the 80s. I know how bad it is. It was bad then and now it's
worse. So we have a motion to defer for 2 weeks until Chris Moody can give us an opinion by Mr. Hard, second by Mr. Gurley House. Is there any objection from the council?
No.
All in favor, say aye. We'll have an answer in a couple weeks.
That's a great book you put
together. It is.
Well, thank you.
Item 14, add Ben Jones to the capital overlay priority road list for consideration. This is put on by Mr. McMorris. It would be time now for somebody that Randy would like to make a motion to add Ben Jones Road. While we're doing this, does anybody else have a road they want to put on the capital overlay list?
Nope.
None. We got a motion by Randy. We have a second.
Second.
Okay. Second by Gerald. Any by Mr. McMorris? Is there any objection? Mm-hmm. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Okay. Section 15. Now, Randy, we took care of this, but do you want to go ahead and address this now and give the waiver, or do you want to let DPW go make the evaluation? This is a waiver request for section 125-27 driveway culverts and subsurface drainage.
Yeah, we already voted on it, let's do it.
Yeah.
We're gonna skip over 15 and you're gonna contact DPW and let them make the evaluation. Okay, item 16, approval of a division of a subdivision plat for Dennis Smith located in Ramon Acres, Fort Folly. Lot 13, 11700 Falcon Crest Drive or 11665 Gory Lane. I've never seen that before. Denver Springs, Louisiana, located in Council District 5. Never seen a lot with two addresses. This is by Mr. Harris. Is Mr. Dennis Smith here?
Yes.
Come on up, Mr. Smith. You got to make a presentation. I think y'all all have a packet. Is this your packet, Mr. Smith?
Yes, sir. That's okay. My packet. Thank you, gentlemen, for letting me speak this evening. Thank you for your time.
State your name and address for us, please. State your name and address for the record. Yeah.
Dennis Smith, 11700 Brown Road or Falcon Crest. On the map, it's Falcon Crest. It's Brown Road, Dennis Springs, 70726. And also, 11665 Gloria Lane is the address of the corner, the complete corner. This is about the request for a division of subplat lot 13 of Roman Acres, fourth filing. And
send that over there and look at yellow.
Okay, sir, go ahead. I was just looking at that.
Actually, I'll just let y'all look at that because it's pretty much everything that I want to say, but I can answer any questions or I can speak about it.
Who's Harry?
The fact that it's two different driveways.
So it's in Bubba's district. So lot 13 is 0.57 acres. When you draw the line, what size are these lots going to be? Do you have any idea?
Yes, sir, exactly. The existing house has got 107 feet, and the rest of it would have, it's on the map of the plat of 13. It was the last one that was divided. That's the last one of that division. And it's the remaining to the other side would be 140 feet.
I'm not concerned about the linear footage on the frontage. How many square feet?
Okay.
Are going to be in each lot because we have an ordinance that says
yes,
that a minimum lot size,
yes,
and without a line drawn, nobody knows if this thing will meet our ordinance or not. So
I understand it's 12,000 and like 500 feet to each lot.
Is going to be approximately 12,500.
Yes, sir. Each lot.
Okay. So it meets that part of the ordinance.
Yes, sir. Lot numbers.
Well, it's lot 13 would become 13A and 13B if it was approved at some point in time.
Yes, sir. And what I'd want to do is I would like to build a house and live in it there and let my son live in the house next door. And it's not accessible. You can't get to Gloria Lane lot except for going through the driveway of Gloria Lane on the same lot. Yes, sir. Sorry, Mr. Butler. Thank you.
What about the, let me find it.
I'm talking about the covenants.
Yeah, covenants on the lots itself. It says no lot shall be re-subdivided or divided into any dimensions other than those shown on the original subdivision plat hereof.
Yes, sir. they put that in there almost 40 years ago, and they divided this lot last. So this lot is definitely an exception to the rest of the divisions. As to the way they did it, you have two driveways and a water meter. Notice there's a water meter on that corner lot, and there's a water meter at the house.
Okay, so I'm confused.
I am too.
Well, no, I'm confused.
I've been
ended up with two addresses on one lot.
Yeah, well, now that's a tentative thing.
So those addresses aren't permanent?
No, sir. Well, it's permanent, but it's an either or. In other words, I can move the driveways and turn it into Glory Lane if I want to.
But you can only have one address in effect at a time.
That's correct. Right now, there's only one address in effect. And what I'm requesting is that I get access to the other lot because it is a bit of a problem maintaining it. There's no access from 11700 Brown Road. You have to go down Glory Lane and turn over the 20-foot driveway. And there's a water meter right there at the corner for that lot.
Okay.
Do you think water, let Mr. Moody look at that and see?
You can hand it off to Mr. Moody and let him make an evaluation, or, yeah, I mean, it's whatever you want to do. If you want to defer it 2 weeks, defer it. Make a motion.
He's going to say, is it part of the subdivision?
It is lot 13 of that subdivision. And the restrictions, as I read them, doesn't identify an initial.
It doesn't say how many.
It says lot 1 through 13. So the original covenants addressed all 13 lots, and that being one of the lots of the subdivision. So if we honor the covenants and our ordinance, then the answer would be no. So I mean,
So if he was to contact all the people living around there and got a petition sign saying that they had no objection, would that change any of our minds as to this?
If the other 12 people in that subdivision didn't care, it wouldn't bother me a lick. But
there's nine on that street.
There's nine.
I understand.
The other ones are down the road.
No, I mean, covenants typically are for the whole subdivision. And I understand they might not be right touching it, you know, but when you go look at property values and how one subdivision lot might affect the property values in the whole subdivision, it affects lot one, whether lot one's on a different road or not. So, I mean, I guess from my point of view, if all other 12 residents were in agreement for the subdivision, I mean, for the subdivided lot.
More than 12.
The division, yeah.
Well, he owns lot 13. So, yeah. I mean, you got to get the.
Just on that last street, one. There's 12. There's more.
There's nine on that street. There's 12 in the whole. There's 13 in the whole subdivision. 13
total. Yeah,
so, nine on that street.
I mean, we can defer it. You can defer it and allow him time to go get a petition signed, requesting the council let you do it, or you can vote no. You have, Bubba, you've got a ton of motions you can make. Would you?
Well,
I can. Can I say something?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
So this ordinance here, I'm talking about the ordinance that's prohibiting this,
right.
Something that I
right you wrote,
wrote. And. I kind of got jammed on the last one because in the covenants it said that you could do it on the other one. So I never in a million years imagined that would be the case, but
it was there.
And so I granted the waiver purely on that. So purely on this, I mean, where it's not even like it's not mentioned, it's in here. You cannot do it. So that's how I'm going to fall, regardless of what Chris moves.
Look, we need to figure out something. We need to make a motion to defer to Chris. We need to make a motion to reject.
Tracy, you make a motion?
I would recommend to him to defer it and come back in 2 weeks. That's what I would recommend to you because he might give some leeway and he might scratch in 5 votes here.
So we're probably going to get a motion to defer. I would strongly recommend in the next 2 weeks, you go talk to your 12 neighbors and get a little petition. And if they signed off on it, it would probably make it a lot easier for some people who have had pretty strong feelings about subdividing lots and subdivisions.
Yes, sir.
Give them the ability to change their vote. Yes. So
I'm not, cool. And I'll say, I'm not sure it would change my mind, but it would definitely give me pause.
Okay, so
what I would like to say is that the lot is a nuisance because it's attractive to dumping. You can't keep it up, and your neighbors don't like it.
Well, go tell your 12 neighbors that, and they'll probably all sign and come back to us. Bubba, you want to put a motion to defer and allow him time to go get signatures? Randy's going to second it. Is there any objection by the members of the council? No. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
So we're going to postpone it 2 weeks. Uh-huh. Go talk to your 12 neighbors, come back with a letter, and they all of them sign on it, and you're probably going to be in good shape.
Okay, so in other words, just because this gentleman on the end is not ever before,
no,
it doesn't mean
I no, no, no.
I didn't say that. I said that. Well,
I'm just trying to figure out what I'm looking at.
You don't need for 5 votes.
Thank you.
I'm trying to say I probably won't, but if you bought those signatures,
people don't really care.
And the original intent was a neighborhood is laid out like this, and when you move in, you buy a property, that's the way you expect it to be.
Yes, sir.
I understand that this is a kind of a different case.
It's an outlier.
But people expect it to be a certain way.
Yes, okay.
And I have to defend that now. Right. But it would make it, everybody there said, I don't care.
I believe if the law was what it is now in the square footage, we would have never been there.
Right.
They would have fixed this.
I hear you.
They never would have had two driveways to one lot with two water meters.
Well, you live for another day. Let's
thank
move
y'all.
On.
Yes,
item 17, board resignation and reappointments. Item A, ratify Fire Protection District number 2, Town of Springfield's board appointment, and Town of Killian's board appointment, and Fire Protection 2, District 2's board appointment by Mr. Galatz.
You have the minutes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'll make that motion.
So Randy makes a motion to accept the appointments by those people. We have a second by Mr. R. Any objection? All in favor say aye. Item 18, committee reports, ordinance, discussion of committee recommendations. Mr. Girlinghouse.
You lost me here.
Ordinance committee. What did we talk about?
18?
Yeah, we're done.
We almost done. We 20 minutes over the projection.
I looked down and all of a sudden we're at 18. What did we discuss? We discussed
Parish-wide letter. Yeah. Parish-wide.
But we're not ready to.
No, we're not even. No.
But just to talk about it, we had a very
informal.
Early discussion about parish-wide garbage pickup. We're going to get some more information on it, and it was a good discussion. We discussed some of the problems that might occur, you know, as far as billing and enforcement. I'm going to have a meeting with somebody like the waste manager just to get the idea of the logistics involved. So we can move forward. We realize that this is going to take some selling, but I think at the end of the day, we all pretty much decided that if it comes down to the price tag, how much is it going to cost the customer? And if we can come in at the same or lower, then we should, because we believe
with,
that
with more services.
Yeah, with more services.
Yeah.
I would recommend that y'all reach out to St. Helena. They actually have that. And it is on your property taxes. And because they do it this way, if you have an address in that area, you can go to their dump for free.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm just telling you, it is done like that over there. So that's someone that you could probably
just reach
out
told
to.
Us it's done on, that's probably what yours is done on.
Yeah.
But
in
St. Helena owns that dump. And,
that's yeah, right. And
that's a different deal here. So.
Yeah, it's a completely different deal. And
that's
too
why,
much to get into.
That's why, yeah. Back, that's why back in the day when the parish owned the dump, if you lived in the parish, it was one you could dump for free, and after the permit was sold and turned over, it changed.
And the rental property, people will rent a property.
And we want to include the pickup in the service.
Right.
So,
yeah.
You know, whatever that price tag is, it'll just be.
And there's only one thing that I'm concerned with, and always have been, is the elderly people in the parish. They may not be able to afford it, and that's
they're doing, they're doing something they're, with it now.
They're doing something with it now. They're that's why I'm saying the price tag is the key.
I know for a while the elderly were getting discounts.
They are.
Well,
and we can look into that. That can be in the bid.
Yes,
if you got a over 65.
Hey.
Oh, Bubba's trying to get a break.
Sound like a little pandering right there. Yeah.
That's a plate.
Hey. Oh, I second that.
Hey, Bubba, if you get 80 down to 60, I'm all in on the discount.
Okay.
Item B, Finance Committee.
We had a meeting tonight. Ms. Jennifer said that our year 2020 is finally up. Everything come out good. But it was $2 million
more than what she predicted.
More than what she projected. And the little secret was the jail will be in the black.
This year?
Cool.
This year.
Cool.
So
I think COVID is restricted moving inmates around. So consequently we're not getting a lot of sending some out, and we're not getting a lot in, so we're
it's
having
amazing,
to
isn't
use
it?
Our bit.
So if we had a little bigger jail, maybe we could keep them all here.
We'll address that another time.
We will.
And she kind of mentioned something to the sense of that, too. That would be a discussion we probably going
to have. No, I mean, once you see.
Sooner than what she thought.
Yeah, once you see that you're not having to pay, you know, once you realize that you don't have to send people out of bed, it significantly reduces the cost of running the thing. Item C, Citizens Drainage Committee. Did y'all ever get to meet Randy? Did that
last night, I think we had two members that were at prior meetings and couldn't attend. They were asking for some backup. They wanted to make sure that council and the administration was on board, because when we was here from the administration and they had questions they wanted to ask, you know, how they would interact to get information. If they, you know, and we're hoping that we get a little more buy-in.
So when's y'all's next meeting scheduled, Randy?
Every first Wednesday or every second, Sandy, every second.
Every second Wednesday. So maybe us councilmen could log it in our deal and show a little support.
And one more thing, I'm not sure if it was Congressman Graves or it was, because I talked to him the other day, but, or the Drainage Committee, there was a special call meeting for Central Parish the same night ours was. And they canceled the meeting 30 minutes before people were to show up. And I got that right up on from the Pelican Post. And so the Pelican Post did an editorial and said that he was pretty sure that we was going to come to an agreement between the two parishes.
Ain't that something?
So I don't know
what transpired. Well, obviously,
the engineering from the Highway 22 project is going to show that it eliminates some serious impact of the pumping on Walworth. If they think they're going to come to resolution, that's the only thing that can be shown.
Mm-hmm. The bottom line is everybody knows that you got to have channels cut through the lake, or you got to do what Ascension does, and you got to have pumping stations and levees. That's the only thing that's going to work. You know, North Pass, like I said before, I take the water, but you got to get it down.
Right.
I agree. Even pumping it that far and doing that, when the wind's in the right direction.
You're wrong, Mr. Bubba. Let me explain to you. Give me a second. Where you pump it is, it's close. You don't pump it far. You pump it close. If you're going to pump it into Bayou Man Shack, that's by the Mississippi River. If you're going to pump it off the 5.5-mile canal that they already surveyed out, fixed to start this summer, that's up right at the Mississippi River. If you're going to pump it right there by the St. James Boat Club, that's right there. So pumping is going to be a least expensive project, I think. But if the rumor is the state's going to be able to take charge of some of that flood things. If I'm not talking politics, if Biden didn't overrule what Trump's already put in place.
Right.
Yeah, well.
I got you. Item 19, there's transport. There is none. Item 20, council comments. Hopefully, we don't have
I've
any.
I've got one. It's very short. It's about me and you. March 6th is going to be Trash Bash Day in our part of the world up there in the northwest corner. There will be roll-off dumpsters at North Park and at the old Down Home Grill. In Watson. I'm going to be at 8 o'clock at North Park. Gary, you going to be on your end?
Yeah, I'm going to be on my end.
Unless something happens?
No, okay. we got a later game.
So anybody that wants to help clean up that park, we're going to clean from Lockhart. Bobby
Saturday, March 6th.
March 6th.
If y'all can incorporate that grapple, Charles can use it on IN, and it's amazing.
I hear you.
It's amazing.
Well, Bobby Joe has got the football teams from Denham and Live Oak, all kinds of different people. They have people lined up to clean every single road from Lockhart Road up to 1019. Awesome. And I'm going to be in charge of picking up the bags and getting them in the roll-off, me and my wife. And imagine Gary's going to be...
I'm going to be in charge of getting a picture made.
I already told you that. See, I said that to him, but that's the only comment I have is that we're going to clean up our parts of the parish. Let's try and get this to go parish-wide next year.
We
get
didn't
it
have
all
to
together.
Write a letter and pick it to do that.
Yeah.
Well, not one, but they're going to throw it out again.
So John, item 21.
You want to do something?
I'd like to make a motion to adjourn.
You got a second?
Yeah.
You got a second one, Mr. Ladd? All in favor?
I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help. Don't be intimidated by large insurance companies who just want to make your problem go away. We are here to represent your rights and interests. Contact me today at tangylawteam.com and let's get to work.